best way to introduce our next speaker is to vehemently say that we need much more people like him. We need his voice, we need his vigorousness, we need his commitment to speaking out what he really feels. Before I even start to describe, as we all know, who Shatrughan Sinha is in our political and cinematic landscape, there's a small story I want to share about him. That when a young girl in some other audience asked him, what did he really look for when he chose films? Was it the script? Was it the dialogue? Was it directors? Was it stories? Was it the banner, the house? He said, I basically looked at the heroine's mother. Shatrughan Sinha has a house called the Ramayan. He has two children. Of course, he has three children, but he has two boys called Love and Kush. And so the other apt description of him is that in an era of false Rams, I think Shatrughan Sinha represents what it is to be a true Ram, to speak for humanism, to speak out, and to constantly follow the moral compass of your own dharma yoga. So let's just look at just some of the things that Shatrughan Sinha has said in our political landscape. We know that there's been a massive crisis in the judiciary a couple of days ago. What Shatrughan ji said was that we need much more people speaking out in public life, not just within the judiciary, but ministers. He has been with this party, the BJP, from a time when it was just a two-seat party to the behemoth it is today. But he consistently speaks out when he thinks that the party is betraying its own principles, or much more importantly, the well-being of the nation. And so, very courageously, I would say, he has described Mr. Modi's government as being a one-man army, two-man show. He has described its cabinet as being made up of 90% ministers that nobody knows of and 10% ministers that nobody respects. He has, of course, praised Mr. Nitish Kumar at different times, but also praised Lalu Yadav. He has basically represented not just what it means to be a stormy petrel in India's public life, but also displayed what many people see as contradiction, but what he calls sportsmanship. And then there is all his pre-life before the world of politics, was of course the world of cinema, where he trod the arc of being what many people have said was the unnatural face to become a hero, because it was a time of Rajesh Khanna and Devanand and the chocolate box heroes. But he moved from being not just a villain, but a hugely successful hero, who again, even in the cinema that he picked in the 70s and 80s, stood up for what really mattered, tried to rescue people. And to understand that entire arc, or that entire cocktail of what makes Shatrughan Sinha that lively, vigorous, much needed voice in our society today, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the man that we really want to hear from, because he is anything but Khamosh, Shatrughan Sinha. I'm very glad to establish that connection with you, sir. You didn't hear what he said. Just before we met, he said, where do you come from? I said, Bengal. But the reason I have the temerity to speak to you is because my grandparents were domiciled in Bihar, and I come from Madhepura, the constituency of Lalu Yadav. And so he just said, okay, I see you have the Madhepura gene in you. And so with that certificate, I'm going to start asking you questions. Let's dive into the contemporary first, and then we'll visit your cinema. You know, as I said, with this whole judicial crisis right now, you said that many more people, ministers within the government, should start speaking up. What are the issues that you feel, sir, that should be highlighted right now? What are the issues that are not being talked about within the government?
Thank you very much, Sama. And before I respond to you, let me, with your kind permission, thank the audience. It's a great audience. Though when I entered, I heard some whistle sound, and I said, "Ki Gurugram aa gaya main lagta hai." This is the welcome to Gurugram, and I welcome all of you. You all are wonderful. In fact, it's beyond expectation. I never thought that this newly born society, organization, NGO, the group would have so many intellectuals and professionals and the best of the people. I salute the organization, and of course I salute my people who have been my source of strength. Thank you very much, all of you. And now I proceed to you. Thank you, Naitha. And what was your question like?
The question was that you know, by the way, if ever anybody Khamosh. Uses...
Tell me, yeah.
If anybody uses social media well, it's Shatrughan Sinha. He's like lighting a bomb a day, you know, on Twitter. So you said, sir, that ministers should start speaking up. I asked you, what are the issues that you feel are not being highlighted and should be spoken about in public discourse right now? What should they be speaking up about?
This is what we all have been taught and we believe in, that party is bigger than an individual and nation is bigger than the party. Nation comes first. Whatever you speak, you must speak with sense of responsibility. In favor of the younger generation, especially, particularly, and the nation in general. After all, whatever we are today, because of our nation and because of our people. So I expect not only from the ministers, whoever has come into politics, or whoever is doing politics, must come forward, must be fearless, and must speak in favor of nation. Whether he's a mantri or a santri, he must come forward. If you're scared, if you're a khushamdeed, if you're a so-called pet troller, if you're a so-called pet chamchas, then rather stay at home. I tell you, most of our people, in politics, from any society, why do they come? Why did they join politics? And most of them without having any commitment, without having any dedication or devotion to the nation, I would say. They come to politics for the glamour of power. Our film industry people also, today you see, a lot of people are coming into politics. One reason could be that films has glamour. Glamour has limited power. Where power has unlimited glamour. And that is why they run after power. Power, politics. Politics is power, and power has unlimited glamour. Most of people come like that. That's why I have to remind them, uthana padta hai, jagana padta hai, ki agar tum nation ke liye aaye ho, desh ke liye aaye ho, to desh ke hit mein baat karo. सामने आओ, डरने से काम नहीं चलेगा. मुझे आज अगर मैं बात करता हूं तो मुझे कोई इस बात की परवाह नहीं है कि वो मेरा कुछ बिगाड़ लेंगे. क्या बिगाड़ेंगे, मैंने ऐसा कुछ गलत किया ही नहीं. अगर मेरा वन ऑफ द यूएसपी है, अगर हमारी इमेज है, तो एक इमेज यही है कि सो कॉल्ड क्लीन हूं. हमारे ऊपर आज तक कभी कोई इनकम टैक्स का नोटिस नहीं, आज तक कभी कोई पुलिस का FIR नहीं. आज तक मैंने हमेशा राइट साइड ऑफ द लॉ रहा हूँ, एंड दैट्स द रीजन आई एम लॉ अबाइडिंग सिटीजन. तो हमारा क्या बिगाड़ेंगे. और वैसे भी चाह गई चिंता गई, मनुआ बेपरवाह, जाको कछु न चाहिए वही शहंशाह.
तो शत्रुजी, जस्ट ओवर दिस लास्ट ईयर, आई जस्ट शेयर सम ऑफ द इश्यूज दैट यू हैव स्पोकन आउट ऑन द पद्मावती इशू, on, you know, all the lynching of the cow lynching, cow protection lynchings that's been happening, on the Aadhaar issue, the fact that the reporters that exposed the Aadhaar, you know, the vulnerability of the Aadhaar, police cases have been filed against them. You have spoken out against, you know, you've called it a banana republic, in fact, because there's so much of oppression of anybody who's speaking up. So the question
Sorry to interrupt. I've never said it's a banana republic. I have reminded them that it's not banana republic. Come out open. It's banana republic, nahi hai ye.
Yeah, you posed it as a question, of course. So, sir, the question I'd like to ask you is that today, in many ways, Mr. Modi absolutely is the most muscular leader, the most successful leader that the BJP has ever thrown up. And you joined the BJP when it was just a two-seat party. But many of the issues that you speak up on, you know, particularly say the cow lynching, the cow protection, even communalism, you know, you're a very staunch believer in India's plurality. So I wanted to ask you, what attracted you to the BJP? What about its ideology attracted you at a time when it was not successful? What did you believe in? Why did you join that party?
To begin with, I could rephrase your question that what made me join politics to begin with. I have been doing anti-tobacco campaign. I have been in the forefront of cancer awareness program. I was greatly inspired by, in the beginning, when only as a star, by my elder brother, late and great actor, Mr. Sunil Dutt. And he introduced me to so many organizations like, or NGOs like Rotary and Lions. There I would go learn from these people and participate, go for some conferences, started learning. Then slowly but surely, I came into contact with so many most respected people of the country and a leader like Jai Prakash Narayan. I was, when I would listen to him, I would almost get mesmerized. And Jai Prakash Narayan, or another great leader who's no more, Nanaji Deshmukh. And I started meeting them, started learning a lot from them. I also happened to meet the great Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji and Lal Krishna Advani ji, whom I always describe as my friend, philosopher, guide, guru, and ultimate leader. Many people think that I have paid some price also for being loyal to him. Many people think that if I am not in the ministry today, it could be also one reason that I have always supported for right cause to Advani ji, or for that matter, my elder brother and statesman, Mr. Yashwant Sinha. Having said this, let me go back to the beginning of my phase when I was, they made me very strong. They said, chalo pehle strong ban jao and then come into politics. Go for the wider horizon from Lions, Rotary or some NGOs. And I thought if I could become a part of the group, a part of the society, a part of the party, a party or party to a party which could improve the situation in the country, which would, could bring the smile on the faces of the have-nots and the poor people of the country, it would be great opportunity, great honor, great fortune for me. And that is how I decided, while right at the peak of my career, not that I was in the Venkaiah Naidu's language, I was not tired or retired. I jumped into politics. Many people thought I was gone mad. My very dear friend, and he's also known as my very dear Sala, brother, my wife's brother, famous director Subhash Ghai. We were very good friends. We did many films together, Kali Charan, Vishwanath, Gautam Govinda, and I jumped into politics and he stopped talking to me. Kya ho gaya? I've gone mad. Politics ko ja raha ho. Paisa kamane ke liye? General impression is that. Paisa kamane ke liye? To paisa to yahan bhi tumhare paas bahut hai. Why? I said, nahi kuch karne ke liye. They thought I'd gone crazy. So I joined politics, got into politics. And then, since I knew so many people, like Atalji, I just said, Advani ji, Nanaji Deshmukh, I thought these are the people, they can never ever compromise with the integrity or with the national security. They would never ever. I thought Bharatiya Janata Party was the best party. I still think the Bharatiya Janata Party is the best party. That's why I joined Bharatiya Janata Party. And that is why time and again I have claimed, regardless of ifs and buts and some fights and tiffs, the Bharatiya Janata Party is my first and last party. That is why I've said. And so, that's why you find me over here.
So I'm going to come back to just probe that question a little bit more. But before that, you have really spoken out in this party. What is the key to the fact that you have never been asked to leave this party? Ram Jeth Mlani has been sacked twice or thrice by the party. What is the secret of your survival?
No, I always believe that honesty and transparency must go together. whatever I have said, the basis of the base has been honesty, and with I go or take transparency. Honesty and transparency goes together. I always believed in it. And second point, which should have been the first point, that after all, we are in a democratic country, democratic society. I just said that I speak in the national interest. And national interest, when I speak, that means I also speak in the party's interest. When I say the denotification, demonetization was not a good thing, log barbaad ho gaye, log raaste pe aa gaye, daily life kharab ho gayi unki, factories band ho gayi. When I said this, that doesn't mean that I'm against my party. When I say the GST, complicated GST after demonetization, well, like neem ke upar karela, you know, neem pe karela. But that doesn't mean that I'm anti-national. Main apni party ke baare mein kuch cheezon pe aina dikha deta. I have also got an experience, humor mein, in of course humor. Recently I was asked a question, not in Gurugram, but I think Chandigarh or even in Delhi. Ki aap, you come from films and you speak a lot on economics, about demonetization, about GST. Aapko itni akal kahan se aage? Aap kaise bol sakte hain, Shatrughan Sinha? Humne kaha kamal hai. Though I had said it in humor, so is baat ko bhi badhana nahi chahunga. I said kamal hai. Agar wakil babu finance pe itni badi badi baatein kar sakte hain, agar ek TV ki actress HRD ki minister ban sakti thi, HRD ki, maine information broadcasting nahi kaha. Ek TV ke actress HRD ki minister ban sakti thi. Aur ek chai bechne wala, aap kehte hain, main nahi kehta hu, chai bechte bechte kahan se kahan pahunch sakta hai, to main itne experience ke baad economics pe baat nahi kar sakta hu. Kyun nahi kar sakta hu bhai? Main bhi kar sakta hu. To ye chalta attitude, but one thing is ki there's no personal enmity against anyone. I hold Mr. Modi in very high esteem. Not only because he's our prime minister, but he's prime minister of the nation. His intention is very good. Aisa nahi unki intention se, bahut acha intention hai. Unki energy level to I think ki shayad, mera khayal hai, Indira Gandhi ke baad agar kisi mein dekh raha hu wo energy level, to main nahi mein dekh raha hu, ghazab ka hai. So we hold him in very high esteem. Agar unko hi koi fail kar raha hai, chahe kami ho rahi hai policy mein, chahe jisme, to usme shayad hum log gunahgar hain. हम लोग जो साथ देने वाले, जिसको आप कह सकती हैं टैलेंट पूल, टैलेंट पूल उसके लिए जिम्मेदार है, वो नहीं है, उनकी तो नीयत अच्छी है. लेकिन कुछ लोग गलत समझते हैं. आप अगर मेरे ट्वीट्स में देखेंगे तो मैं कभी प्राइम मिनिस्टर के खिलाफ नहीं बोलता. वो उनके पास समय बहुत कम है, इतना बड़ा देश है, इतने काम है उनके पास, बहुत काम. हम कभी कभी कोशिश करते हैं विद ऑल गुड इंटेंशन टू शो द मिरर.
So, isme, you know, I'll come. We've actually that not yet answered that question, so I'm going to come back to it. But just to speak about the more immediate, to bring home to this audience, Shatruji, ki just before your session, in fact, we had a session with a young Muslim mother, and she was talking about the experience of mothering young children, Muslim children in this country, and the kind of unconscious prejudice that they have to face. It's just natural that you know, amongst all the other kind of bullying, that they will face a bullying for being a Muslim. You have consistently spoken out, as I said, against communalism. You know, you have spoken out even on the lynching. So, for instance, the film Padmavati, you know, do you feel that it should be released as is, or do you agree with the way that that people are offended and so this film is stopped?
So, Ma, I respect your this question, but the question is a bit too late now. You see, I am the one who had given, not only given a very balanced opinion, which they found about the whole episode. I had also said, can such an issue, rather a burning issue, don't expect Mr. Amitabh Bachchan to speak for this, or Mr. Shahrukh Khan and other people. But first and foremost, our friend and one of the best filmmakers in Asia, Mr. Sanjay Leela Bansali should himself speak. He should speak out. The nation cannot become his spokesperson unless he speaks himself. We must know the direction. And more important, as I said, call it a burning issue. Our information, Honorable Information and Broadcasting Minister, or for that matter, our Honorable Prime Minister, whom I have always described as a dashing, dynamic, and action hero, Narendra Modi, they should have spoken. Why involve me and you, anybody else? But having said this, also let me tell you, the Karni Sena, the warrior, the people, the brave people, those who have sacrificed their life for the nation, and they for the dignity of the woman, if they consider our lady, the lady Padmavati, as the role model, mother figure, sister figure, or the lady of the personality in totality par excellence, agar unko consider karte hain, it was a contract between our friend Sanjay Leela Bansali and the Karni Sena, those great people. There was a contract. They had said that they will show the film before release to the intellectuals of the Karni Sena. Some people would come. CEO had also given it in writing. Now, jab baat bahut badh gayi, everybody started talking about this. And instead of showing it to the intellectuals from Karni Sena, Rajput community, the great warrior community, what they did? They did and called some of our friends from the media like Arnav Goswami, our friend Rajat Sharma, and they showed it to them. I said, kya chalo achha hai, wo bhi bura nahi hai. But when you can show it to them, why can't you show it to our intellectuals, the Karni Sena people, the Rajput community? After all, it's the matter of their pride, the dignity, the lady, the role model. I do not know. I have not seen the film. I have not gone through the history also. But for that matter, let me tell you, Karni Sena people were very kind of them. Film people also appreciated my view. And for Karni Sena people, they arranged a very big program in Patna last time when I was there. And they honored me. It was a chock-a-block, absolutely house-full scenario. Well, they all lady, gents, all young girls, younger generation, they all came and, of course, they gave me big honor for being so honest, forthright, and coming out with balanced views. So, ab late ho gayi hai. Suma, ab late ho gayi hai. Because the 25th ko release hai. Ab kuch karke, I don't want to add fuel to the fire. I hope, wish and pray, ki sab kuch smooth ho jaye. Dono se vida, not at the cost of our people, the warrior community, the great Rajput community or the Karni Sena people, unko bhi koi daag na lage, aur film ko bhi koi chot na pahunche. Ab to hum yahi chahenge. I hope, wish and pray.
So, Shatruji, I'll shift a little bit to cinema and then come back to politics. But before that, just two quick questions. You just said that Mr. Modi is like an action hero. You know, we were talking, I asked you that question about communalism. There are all these lynchings, but Mr. Modi has not spoken out. He has not tweeted. Do you think that, yes, it's a very large country. Do you think our action hero doesn't know about this going on in the country? Do you think it's fair that the Prime Minister doesn't speak out on this issue?
When he doesn't speak out, that is why I speak out, no? Wo tweet nahi kar rahe, tabhi to main tweet karta hun. After all, we belong to the same party. अभी तो पार्टी में हूं ना
तो आप पार्टी का मर्यादा आप कायम रखे हैं
जी हम मर्यादा पुरुषोत्तम का इतना ध्यान तो रखना चाहिए ना
सो द ओरिजिनल क्वेश्चन आई वांटेड टू आस्क यू शत्रुजी एंड आई विल क्विकली शिफ्ट टू सिनेमा देन वी विल कम बैक टू पॉलिटिक्स इज दैट यू हैव डिस्क्राइब्ड मिस्टर अडवाणी एज रियली योर मेंटर योर गाइड यू नो अ वेरी ग्रेट स्टेट्समैन एंड द क्वेश्चन आई वांटेड टू आस्क यू इज दैट बिकॉज यू आर सो कमिटेड टू द आइडिया ऑफ अ प्लूरल इंडिया एंड टू you know, every community having rights within this country. But Mr. Advani was the original ideologue, the communal ideologue on the Babri Masjid movement. You know, the Babri Masjid fell under his time. He led the Rath Yatra. Today, he is considered a statesman in comparison to the way the Sangh Parivar and the RSS and the BJP are behaving. So why do you differentiate between the BJP of today and Mr. Advani's politics when you believed in him?
BJP of today and BJP of yesterday. As far as BJP of yesterday is concerned, I could recite these lines. Chhodo kal ki baat purani. Naye daur mein likhenge, milkar nayi kahani. Hum Hindustani. Ho gayi baat. Ab jo hui so hui. Ab hum aage kaise leke desh ko chalna hai. Aur kahan tak chalna hai. Economic progress ke saath. Pride ke saath. Peace, prosperity ke saath. Usko dekhna hai humko. Ab to ho gayi. Pehle humne ke main nahi janta hu kya sach hai kya nahi hai. Bahut sare titles you would agree. Bahut sare titles media created hote hain. Jaise mera khud hi shotgun. Main kahan se shotgun hu bhai. Wo bana diya shotgun. Chal raha hai. Jaise little master. Master Blaster, Amitabh Bachchan Emperor, Badshah Khan, Shah Rukh Khan. Ab hain ki badshah hain ki fakir hain, hum nahi jante. Lekin banaya hai logon ne. Emperor, I'm sure Amitabh Bachchan, hamare dost jo hain, legendary star Amitabh Bachchan, unko khud bhi shayad Emperor title pasand nahi hoga, Big B. To pehle sunta tha ki ye hua aur wo hua. Ab kaun jeeta hai teri zulf ke sar hone tak, baat gayi, raat gayi, badnaam hua, subhash gayi. Baat khatam.
So, as I said, you know, you have views on Nitish Kumar, you have views on Rahul Gandhi, you have views on so many people. I'm going to come back to all of that. But first, Shatruji, you know, let's start with your movies. There's a lovely story in your biography that Amitabh Bachchan was very, very jealous of you. He did not want you to be part of Kala Patthar. Is that a true story? And what do you think, Lee, why were you making people...